So what's the story, Joe? How's the lockdown treating you?
It was hard at first because I'm a baker, so obviously I can't work from home. So I've been out, it's going into now, from Tuesday would be my 10th week off. So at the start it was kind of, it was great for the first week or so, you know what I mean? Yeah, exactly. And it's just, then I found the mental side of things starting to not get in on me, but you're looking for stuff to do. And I think the strangest part of lockdown was they closed all the hardware stores. Yeah. Like everybody's at home looking for stuff to do, DIY stuff, and like you can't buy it.
And not being able to leave the house, you know, you can't leave your house only for the essentials. And now like, you know, you're on holiday mode, but like you're thinking to yourself, right, what's the crack here?
Yeah, yeah. So I wanted to paint the back fence. Couldn't get the paint. It was the mental side. it was the mental side of things I found tough at the start, but once you kind of keep yourself busy, which we'll talk about in a minute, you kind of get through it. It just seems like Groundhog Day.
Yeah.
Every day it's just like, it's not Monday, Tuesday, or it's day. Every day is the same.
It was like the weekend. Every weekend, it was like every Saturday.
Yeah, yeah. It was strange because my wife, she was working from home. She's been like all the time. So this is her little office space here.
So
I have to sit sitting there and watch. If I see another episode of The Chase, I'm gonna absolutely kill Bradley Walsh.
You should be on The Chase at this stage.
Stop. I don't know. It's unbelievable.
What would be your nickname? We won't call you the Dark Destroyer, won't we?
What you want.
Keep it clean, Joe.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. I don't usually, but I'm the interviewee today, so I have to stay quiet.
So, you were saying that you're a baker. Like, I say you were doing, like, you say your appointment is a baker, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
So were you doing a lot of baking at home?
I never done it at home at all. No. I never. It's like my wife says, she's sick of looking at computers when she comes home. It'd be the same for me.
Yeah.
I never, ever, ever baked at home. Never even did children's birthday cakes. Tesco, Fiverr, Fish Bash Box. Yeah.
Well, my other half, John says she's been doing a lot of baking. Like, she's been baking her own bread. She's a fabulous, fabulous cook. Mm. And she's been baking. I've been saying, I would love to be able to bake like herself or cook like herself. But you know, I burn my fingers more than anything else. <You know>? So I've just been eating. You know what I mean? Things like that, And come here. You started doing these the Joe lockdown quizzes.
It was actually kind of a selfish reason, to be honest, because like I said, I was looking for something to keep myself busy, keep myself occupied. So it would have been the week after Patrick's Day, which I think was the 20th of March. So I said I'd do a Facebook quiz for the crack, Facebook Live, and so we got a good response. I got a good response from the people, but not Facebook. I got a 1 month ban after the first one.
What did you do?
I actually looked back at the video and I don't think I did that too. No, I had like two or three Jack Daniels, but nothing. I didn't, because I was conscious that there was kids watching, do you know what I mean? So I looked back and said, I didn't do anything bad there. And then I said, maybe somebody reported me.
Was it copyright reasons? Did you use music in it or anything like that?
No. So. Anyway, you got a month ban from Facebook Live, so I set up. Yeah.
So well, I set up. You covered Joe already, were you? Were you charging people like €20 to go?
Oh, it was free. No. Oh, yeah. I wish I did. Actually, you wouldn't be sitting here. I'd be in the Bahamas or somewhere. Yeah. But I set up a different Facebook, a fake profile of Joe Lockdown Quiz.
That's where it came from. That's where I liked it. Yeah. Yeah.
So I sent a friend request to a lot of other friends, and some people who didn't want it just didn't, you know what I mean? So So we started doing that then. That was on the 20th. So I did it for 7 weeks, every Saturday night.
Yeah, I saw great feedback from it because everybody that I knew, because we're kind of have mutual friends on Facebook. So everybody I knew was either doing the Joe Live quiz. I tuned into the first one, and as soon as I saw, I like my football and I like the sport and all that, but I'm not good with the football quizzes. And as soon as it came in, I was I hear it now. No, I'm gone. That's it. I still kept on track and I was still listening in, and I saw a lot of people looking in, and I started seeing you doing the kids one, and they say, "Maybe the kids one might do me good," it would be easier. But you seem to get a lot of following. That's why I decided, why not have a chat with yourself, the man doing the quiz. How are you getting on with it, and do you find it stressful? Do you find it getting annoying? Or do you love doing it? And would you still keep doing it when you're going back to work?
No, I get to it now. I really, really enjoyed it at the start because it was a way, everyone's sitting in the house.
Yeah.
They don't get outside the house. So it's just a way of interacting with people and the chat would be coming in and the odd slag of it. No, me, I just walk off and look back. It wouldn't bother me. But it just snowballed, you know what I mean? And at one stage, we'd I think there was 100, now it would have been 150 people watching, but one of them is a family in a house, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Or three or four people in a house. So with people from Denmark, Belgium, obviously the UK, Ireland, San Francisco, San Diego, New York, Toronto.
Oh, listen,
listen.
Friends or family or anybody that you have. On the Facebook,
Listen to me. It only lasted an hour and a half, 2 hours max.
Yeah.
It's just literally a bit of crack, something to take your mind off everything. That's what it was.
It's a bit of fun for everyone and for yourself. And how did you manage? Did you let so many people in so you're not overcrowding yourself and being yourself? You're just all free to talk
Anyone who wants to come in, just come in. And it's great because I can't see them. It's not like Zoom.
Yeah,
you can see the face. Or you can just see me on the screen. Or you can just waffle away and drink Jack Daniels and
talk to yourself as usual.
Yeah, exactly. Well, but this time someone was actually listening. But it just snowballed and snowballed, and everyone seemed to enjoy it. But it just got to the stage after about 6 weeks. I remember I've been doing other things, which we'll get to in a minute.
Yeah.
But, I remember the wife says to me, "Oh, you look very tired in that video." And I feel fine. I said, no, you just look tired. And it's okay. And then someone else messaged me saying, "Okay, Joe, so you look wrecked." Oh, my grand. But then I said, maybe I'm just doing a little bit too much.
Yeah.
Even though I felt fine and my sleep wasn't affected and strange.
You're looking forward to it. You're just probably
shocked. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Because the prep for the quiz would start probably...
You know, Letty, don't you? Sorry, just come
in. I do indeed.
No.
Hello. Lovely nasal hair view there.
Phoebe Virgin.
So, it was strange because I didn't feel bored or stressed or anything. And like I said, the prep started probably Tuesday, Wednesday, where I'd go on and I'd get, we just did 30 questions. That's what it was.
Yeah,
I did 15 questions, and then my son, who is kind of a musician, he's very, very good. Only learning.
What's that himself, was it? Yeah.
That's Dean, he's my son, yeah. Wow. So he would come in, do a couple of tunes half time, and then I'd do the other 15. Like I say, he enjoyed it as well, but he had to kind of, he missed a couple of weeks because he was still doing college work.
Of course.
He had a couple of assignments, but he's finished now, so happy days.
Jeez, dude.
Yeah, so seven weeks. Yeah, 7 weeks I went on for, and I just decided, listen, enough is enough. 7 weeks of looking at my emotions is enough for anybody.
So, I look forward to it, Joe. Keep
going. So I stopped it then, and it was too far then, because people said, keep it going. Come on, we missed the quiz. And I missed it then. I was like, geez, come Tuesday, Wednesday, I have nothing to do.
Exactly. You need to prepare. You think to yourself, prepare. And I think it's having the like as we were saying at the start, it's like the normality of having like, you know, tonight's a Friday night, tonight's a Saturday night. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Let's break up the week of having doing a quiz. Like you probably had a set day to sort out the questions, or was there much preparation for yourself, or did you just go with the flow?
It was more so fact checking the questions, because I just went to different websites, copy and pasted the questions. But the very first week it was strange, because one of the questions was to do with star signs.
Okay.
And as I had was Sagittarius, but the actual answer, I hadn't a clue about star signs. I'm not even going there.
No, don't go there. Don't bring it back up.
But someone said, "Oh no, the answer was Aries," and a few other people, "Yeah, the answer was Aries." I said, "That's just a free quiz." What do you mean?
But listen, man, it's like if you did this quiz in a pub anywhere, the same thing would happen. There's always that person that was saying, "Oh, this is the right answer." Yeah. No, this, there's always that controversial answer, as I always think. Like this, and we do like family quizzes as well.
Yeah.
And so, like, I was always the news of bread, right?
Yeah.
So, like, one of the questions I did was about the Live Aid 1985 one, and like we opened up for that, and a lot of people said Queen, where actually was
Status Quo.
Now that's going to make me look dumb, stupid there, because every person that I asked that always said Status Quo, and it's maybe not controversial enough, but there's a few. Younger crowd that haven't seen Live Aid, whatever, would always say Freddie Mercury, you know, Queen straight away,
That's basically because they were the best act on the day. Excuse me. So I think especially for people who weren't around or weren't born then.
Yeah.
Or even but amazing concert. Have it on DVD. I keep threatening to break it out and sit down with it. Couple of flagons like I did back then. Watch.
Oh, I do. It's nice to watch back. Like, I actually watched back the Queen on YouTube one of the days.
Yeah.
It wasn't working. And I had it on Bluetooth, and they're saying I watched just the whole Queen version of it when they're online.
Amazing.
Oh, it was really cool. But sorry, let's get back to you. But like, where were you? Oh yeah, you were saying about the Aries, like, you know, but like, those things happen, like, and how did you manage to deal with that? Like, as you said, it's a free quiz, like, just go.
There was no prizes involved. Well, initially, there was no prizes involved. So I said, listen, it's a free quiz. Who cares if all the answers are wrong? it's only a distraction, not like mastermind or anything like that. So, but then, like I said, going back to what I said earlier, I got enough, so I said, right, we'll stop. 7 weeks, that's enough. And then people said, come on, bring it back. And I said, no. And we left it. And then tomorrow actually would have been the women's mini marathon, which is obviously called off.
So yeah, I was going to mention about that, because I was checking out your history in the lockdown and all that. And I noticed that you're doing a fabulous work of raising money for the women's mini marathon?
It's for the Irish Cancer Society, which my wife would have done the fundraising for. So again, I just said we'll restart, do one more quiz. I call it The Last Dance. It's very topical.
I won't go there.
So,
not at the bend again, Joe.
So I said I'd charge people a fiver.
Good.
And then we'd see where we go. And I said to Donna, like, we'll get a couple of hundred, 300 euro. And as we stand up to 15 minutes ago, it's 1,060 euro.
Nice one, Joe. Well done.
I'm just blown away.
Yeah.
I'm really stuck. Just a bit of crack.
That's brilliant, though. Like, a lot of people just donated the way they did it.
Yeah, I set up a GoFundMe page, and people listen, I charge a fiver. Some people threw in a fiver, a couple of people threw in 50.
Well,
you know what I mean? It's just amazing. Absolutely.
Amazing how some people aren't they? Just still out there. Yeah, very generous. Yeah. Like, obviously, they see the work that you're doing, like, you know, and, like, you're entertaining them, and they want to give a little bit back, like, especially for such a great cause.
Exactly. Like, the charities are getting hit big time, you know, with this lockdown. Especially, like, the Cancer Society, they have the Daffodil Day, which is kind of, I remember seeing the programs probably about 30% after
the charitable. When was the Daffodil? I know that was cancelled, wasn't it?
I think it was, could have been April time. I'm not quite sure of the date.
Yeah, I think that was the first kind of events that were kind of starting to be cancelled. Like, a lot of the charity events, as you say, is being, like, affected a lot. And, like, the best they can do is these live Facebooks and like they keep going with them, like.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. But I don't know whether you watch the Late Late Show. I don't watch it except for hate. It's ridiculous. It's just an advertising. It's an advertising thing for RTE. But over the last couple of weeks, they've had like a different charity each night, and people donate. And I think like there was one there a couple of weeks ago, PA the House.
Oh yeah,
they raised nearly 2 million.
It's amazing.
It's just stunning. It's just like I said, people are good.
Yeah,
people are good. Yeah.
Except when the Aries question comes up, then the NY have an argument.
I might actually throw the charity quiz now is tonight, so I think I'll just throw that back in for the crack.
And like, how many?
I put the right answer. Oh no, I put another wrong answer. I put Capricorn.
Capricorn, yeah. Just put whatever someone says. If they start arguing, yeah, that's fine. That's the right answer. No good.
Yeah.
But like, how do you find it when you're doing these quizzes? Like, as you said, you have the charity thing tonight. Now, how do you feel? Like, I'm saying, like, you know, it's your flow with it. You just go with it. Like, as you say, is it obviously live on Facebook? And you just
Facebook go live, yeah, Facebook live. Just sit on the opposite side of this table, and I have a couple of a cardboard cutout with Gilfie Sigurdsson. He sits behind me. He's my wingman.
I'll be the next.
I have a special guest tonight, which I can't say anything about. Yeah, but you'll see later. Yeah.
Well, that's the same with me tonight, Joe. There's people asking me, who's your next, who are you talking to? And I says, I'm a special guest, not going to tell anybody, who is it on, who is it? No, can't say a word, cannot say a word of it.
I'm going to be disappointed when you see me.
Oh, you
better, you're
better,
oh, you're not him again.
You better do a dance or something.
Yeah. Not him again, I'm out of here.
And then you're doing like a lot, like, offside of the lockdown quizzes, like, I know you, I met you from the Irish Toffees. The fantastic Everton Supporters Club.
Yeah.
And that was through my good friend, Mr. Owen Carney. And how's that going now? Like, I've seen hearing you doing a few interviews with a few like football legends, would it be right?
Yeah, it's kind of, it's, going back to it, it's a selfish kind of thing, it's a two-way thing, it's giving me something to do. So I said to the lads, we'll start up an Irish Toffees podcast, and we'll try and interview a couple of experts. So, well, I got very good friends with Kevin Sheedy.
Yeah.
So I said, I'll ask him. He's no problem, whatever. Like, they're all doing nothing either. They're sitting at home. You know what I mean? So, yeah. So I've done six or seven. I think Kevin Sheedy, Kevin Ratcliffe. Anyone who's not an Everton fan is probably saying, who are all these lads? But Kevin Sheedy, Kevin Ratcliffe, Joe Parkinson.
Parkinson, yeah. Remember the I was on that night with Joe Parkinson's alright.
That was in the Red Cow or City West. Yeah. That was out in the Red Cow, I think.
That was right there. That was another Everton night when Stephen, as you call it, himself, Stephen Spilabedigo.
So I did Joe Parkinson, Derek Melfield, which is a very good one. I just finished last night, Gareth Farley, I interviewed him. That was excellent. Like, he's flying now. He's like a top lawyer.
Yeah.
He's on a panel for the Court of Arbitration Sport. And like
can I ask, right? You must be a great PR because you're getting all these contacts, or is one of the lads helping you from the Irish Toffees? And like contacts.
No, you know me, so I might talk to anybody.
I know that, Joe. Yeah.
No, but I always ask people, if you don't do, you don't do. They can only say no.
So,
but it'd be because I'm a season ticket holder at Everton, I'm over there quite a lot. So I would see a lot of these fellas after a match in the pub or in Winslow, which is literally just across the road. So I wouldn't get the phone numbers. I'm not that forward. I'd get a photograph, and then I'd have people who know their people, that kind of way.
Okay, and that's where you kind of get your kind of base sorted out. And as you say, they're probably more delighted that you asked them.
We've been actually quite busy because, today we should have been playing a match in Goodison.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah, there was like 44 of us going over to play, and that got cancelled. Obviously, with the lockdown and everything, but we had to go through a process.
Did you do that last year for the Jim Memorial one as well?
No, that's a separate match.
Oh, okay, sorry.
We did it. The first time we did it was in 2017 for the 25th anniversary of the club. We started in 92, which Jim Carney, as you know, he wouldn't have started up the club. So then that was 2017. And then he thought, come on, can we do that again? So we did it last year. Went over, 44 of us went over. Hired out Goodison for 3 hours, full pitch, dressing rooms, the whole.
I would love to see that one. If I'd be right, Ron would have been on that trip as well,
yeah.
Peter as well, yeah.
Peter Healy. He would have been on the first one. And then, tragically, he passed away in an accident, but he's still there.
Yeah.
He's still there. I talk to Pete regularly. Pete said, what's going on? No, you met Pete yourself.
Yeah,
meet Peter once.
That's it.
Are you
in contact with Ronan as well?
Ronan used to be on the committee for years, but he stepped down, but he still has one foot in. He looks after all the IT stuff and Twitter and the web page and all. So Ronan's still there. There's 5 people on the committee, but there's so much more. The subcommittees of football matches and events and we have a golf society.
We'll go back to the Goodison. You were supposed to be on this, and it would have been a fabulous day to be there. I say you'd be heartbreaking not being there again, but you'd be back in Goodison someday.
I can't say it being this year, to be honest. This calendar year. But like I said, the Irish Tops were busy repaying because everyone had paid. So we had to refund everyone and go back, and it was actually harder paying back the money than I was getting it. It was just actually the doing it. Because they send you by PayPal, someone sent bank transfer, and then you're trying to contact people to get their bank details.
It's a lot more stressful, isn't it?
Exactly. It is what it is,
Do you have many more interviews with the Everton legends, or is there any more in the lined up?
I kind of have them overlap. So actually, very very good one I did last week. I interviewed Farmer Michael and Kathleen, the comedian guy.
Yeah,
because they're big Everton fans and a big link. I interviewed them. They sat in the car and I interviewed them, which was, it was excellent. It was good fun. So then, last night I did Gareth Farley.
Oh, wow. He said,
someone lined up next to it, I can't say. Then, when I prepped the interview for them next Friday, from Wednesday on, I start looking for another guest. You know what I mean? So, I always have someone ready.
Do you find it hard? Obviously, you have somewhere, you have a contact somewhere that you wouldn't you'd be grand.
I just messaged a couple of people. Two of the interviews, Kevin Ratcliffe and the person I have coming up next week, I just messaged them on Twitter. Private message. You want to come on?
So Sir Paul McCartney, I wonder if he's busy.
But actually, going back to the 25th anniversary of the club, we had a gala dinner down in Mullingar, and before that, I asked people, would you send a good luck, congratulations on 25 years? I asked, I swear to God, I asked everybody from Dustin the Tucky to Donald Trump. If people come into my mind, I'd write them down and I'd send a message. Like I said earlier, they can only say no.
Exactly. That's the worst thing that can happen.
One of the nicest ones I got was, do you watch Gogglebox?
Yeah, I do. Now,
remember Leon and June, the old couple who used to sit in the armchair watching TV?
She was an Evertonian. John was an Everton fan, wasn't he?
Yeah. So they sent me one, but he passed away a couple of months later. And she sadly passed away about 2 or 3 weeks ago.
Months ago, isn't it?
Well, again, I just ask anybody.
Go for it. myself. Dear Dustin,
I always think if you throw out for an up for odds, you get a fish. You know what I mean? Yeah. So
just go for it.
But it just, I'd say it's time, I'll ask anybody anything.
Yeah. I know you're very good as well, like, for doing the quizzes. And like I just said, as I said, just go for a chat with Brody. And then I said, I'm chatting with yourself. And as I said, I got a bit of a good reaction just to having a chat. And people just seem to like just going in and seeing people just having a one-to-one chat and having a beer. Like I was going to say, like, for our charity, when the pubs reopen, would you ever think about going into the profession, doing like pub quizzes in pubs and all that, like doing Joe Lockdown, like a live event?
I wouldn't be against it, but this way, somebody wants to throw me a couple of hundred quid once a week.
You go for it.
Or even just a few pints of Heineken. So just you can drink while they're doing the quiz. So I do like 600 questions.
You go with it. I'm going to tell you what, since you're always asking the questions, right, Joe? I'm going to give you a quick fire round and see how you do. You ready for it?
Oh, lads. Okay, let me take a swig first. Let me
no worries.
Whistle.
You see your phone? You're not cheating or anything like that? No Google.
That's what I always say when I'm doing the quiz. Like, there's no prizes. So what's the point in cheating? You're only cheating yourself.
Exactly. Don't worry. You get a prize if you win these. If you get these, all these. How many questions have you got? 1, 2, 3, 4 questions. If you get all four right, you win a prize. All right.
All four.
All four right. You win. Don't worry. Bring it on. No choices. There's A, B, or C. Right. So not leaving you in the dark. Okay.
Okay. Right. Go for it.
Do you want to go first with literature or music?
Music.
Okay.
Oh, very professional.
Are you ready for this? Which section of an orchestra is sometimes known as the kitchen sink department? Is it A, woodwind, B, strings, or C, percussion?
I say percussion because they make the noise.
That is correct, Joe. Well done, Joe. Right.
Shark. Thanks, Google.
Right. God. Sport or technology?
Sport, please.
Sport. I knew you'd go for this one. I was there going like, I was looking on Google earlier on and saying, I'm going to have to get hard with Joe because he'd be very good with sport quizzes. But listen.
So is this hard?
I think this is an easy one. This is an easy one. Right.
Okay.
Go for this one. If you don't know this one, I'm gone, right? Complete the catchphrase of boxing MC Michael Buffer. Let's get ready to what? Is it A, rumble, B, rock, or C, rampage?
I think it's, let's get ready to rumble.
Your Saturday night starts here. With Joe Lockdown Quiz.
Yes.
Right, buddy. We're on the last two, and we have another one, literature or technology?
I'll go with literature.
Literature again, my friend. Okay. One of his favourite sayings, screw it. I start again. One of his favourite sayings, screw it, let's do it, is the title of an advanced book by which entrepreneur? Is it A, Richard Branson, B, Alan Sugar, C, Peter Jones, or G, Joe Lockdown Quiz?
I could actually be the answer, but... what let's do it. I'll go with Branson.
You having me on, Joe? You're doing this pausing for effect.
Is that right?
It was right. Hey, yeah.
And I was actually going to say Alan Sugar, but then no, he's a lord. You might not say screw it.
I would have gone for Alan Sugar for me. You know, right? I always look at them as going like Alan Sugar. Right, last one, Joe. We're going to have to go for technology this one. You got no option, right?
The last one for the prize.
Last one for the prize, right? You ready? In 1992, the first text message, sorry again. In 1992, the first text message sent to a phone said what? A, Merry Christmas. B, Happy Birthday. Or C, You're Dumped. The first text message.
I'd like to think it was You're Dumped. I'd really rude. I'll go with Happy Birthday.
Happy Birthday? Is that your final answer?
Oh, you put me under pressure now because I want to say Merry Christmas.
Would you like
to go happy birthday?
Happy birthday. Right. You went for B, happy birthday. I do apologize, Joe. That is the wrong answer. It is A, Merry Christmas.
That's what I said, Merry Christmas.
Oh, okay, Joe. We went back. You went for a B, though.
B was Merry Christmas, no?
No, B was happy birthday.
Oh, sorry, sorry. Oh, I meant Merry Christmas.
Another controversial one. Right. Yeah. So I say you're looking forward to a few of the pubs opening soon enough, so you get the Irish Toffee Boys back out again and watch the football and all of that. I say you're missing it, are you?
Just missed it. Like, I'm a really, really social person. Like that, you know, like I said earlier, I like to talk. I just like to talk. It's just a social aspect. Even if you sit out in the beer garden, like 10 feet from somebody, have a couple of pints, just to converse with people. That's the thing I miss mostly. Don't miss. Listen, nobody misses going to the pub itself.
Yeah.
It's who's in the pub or who you're going to see.
Exactly,
That's it. And we're certainly not missing the prices of pints.
No.
Like, it's, I mean, like a box of Miller, 20 bits.
Yeah, happy like, out.
Yeah, 2.5 points you get for 20 bits.
You don't get a taxi home either. You're there in the couch.
Yeah, exactly. But we'll get there eventually. But I think everyone's world has just changed. I feel sorry for the younger generation, for the kids.
Yeah.
Like we've done what we need to do. I don't mean to be maudlin, you know. Like we've got advantage. We've done all the crazy stuff, but it's just going to be a totally different world when we come out the other side. Yeah,
it is, isn't it? You can see.
Listen, lots of that. People have died as well, you know this, so you have to kind of remember that.
That's it. Like,
and
like, fair play to the health workers as well. Like, we're working. Like, we've been it's just been crazy in work. And like I said, look forward to your quizzes and everything that everybody just entertaining. Like, I don't want to keep mentioning it, but like with Facebook, but that's your base. Like, you know what I mean? And we're doing it. Like, you know, and I really appreciate you saying yes to having a chat with me. I know I'll probably text you early in the morning, but I just said, you know what? I haven't seen Joe in a while. I said, I got on, self and Joe know each other from the Irish Toffees first off. But like recently at a very famous wedding, Katrina and Owen, and we got on like a house of fire as always. Yeah. And like I just said, you know, it'd be nice just to, because we can't meet up, we can't just say, I'm sure, like, you know, I meet you, you know, watch match, meet you in the pub.
Yeah.
This is the best thing to do, like, you know what I mean?
Next best thing, yeah, exactly. Yeah. Like I said during the interview yesterday, I never heard of Zoom before all this. Never.
Now
you're doing, like, you're doing Zoom with the family, you're doing bingo, you're doing it's mad.
It is,
yeah. So I think people just come up with different things. Just again, going back to the very start, it's to keep your mental side ticking over.
Exactly, yeah.
Keep you busy, keep you occupied, keep you doing stuff. Or people who aren't working at home, obviously. But then, like you said there a few minutes ago, like the frontline workers need a bit of escape.
Mm.
You know what I mean? So it's an ideal quiz for an hour and someone enjoys it.
It's a bit of crack, like, you know what I mean?
Listen, at the end of the day, it's just a bit of crack.
That's a couple
of beers.
And I might ask your son for a Zoom chat since he's a musician, if he's up
100%,
for it.
100%, yeah. I'll
try it
to him, yeah.
That'd be good. Right, my friend, I better let you go. You're a busy man, and you'll be doing your... What time is it there now? It must be nearly...
It's 6:45, is it? Yeah, so I'm on stage.
I better let you go.
I'm on stage at 9 o'clock. Yeah, I'm on stage at 9 o'clock, so I had to go and get my makeup done and get hair and all.
Ready, get your best side done, get your...
get the props ready. I have a special guest ready tonight. Special guest. I'll let you in on the secret. Don't put this on out tonight. It's Sharon Ibuela.
Right, okay, no worries.
If you give me a second, I'll get her and I'll show you.
Right.
So, a little bit of a story behind this. We do a family bingo every week. And
before you go, Joe, before you start, I'll be putting this out tonight. I think I'll be putting it in next Friday, just to give the other video a bit of a calm down and something to look forward to.
That's happy days. So the secret won't be out tonight.
No, no, it won't be out tonight. Don't worry.
A little bit of a background to story. We do a family bingo every week. And there's different hosts, and we have prizes and whatever. So I won one of the, I think it was a line, a four corners, whatever. So my daughter said, your prize is a cardboard cutout of anybody you want. And I was like, Sharon Eve Whalen. Just what? Why'd you ask me what I wanted? So, there's Sharon Eve Whalen. Hold on. Me and the Shasta.
Looking well.
Yeah.
Looking very dressed up. So keep your social distance, Joe.
It's full length. It's full length.
How does she do that? Does she work in that company or something?
I don't know. I didn't ask her. Send me Sharon the Whale on.
I'm gonna say to you, Joe, can you get me a quote out of Joe Duffy?
Talk to Joe.
Talk to Joe.
What kind of cardboard cut out with me?
Which is your best side there? Oh, you at the computer desk.
Out the back. On the back.
Listen, Joe, my friend, I really appreciate it. Get the beers in again.
You look after yourself. Stay safe. Listen, look after yourself, buddy. Bye-bye. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.